everybody, it's Nina. Thanks for joining me today for a new tutorial, and I'm very excited to be part of Sugar Pea Design's 4th birthday celebration. This birthday blog hop is celebrating Sugar Pea Design's 4th birthday, so they've been around for 4 years, which is really awesome and so happy for Wendy and her fabulous company. I'm going to be a guest in their blog hop celebrating this wonderful achievement, so you can head on over to my blog. I'll have links down in the video description where you can find out more information on the blog hop, including prizes, and of course you can get more information on this card that I'm creating, which features their beautiful Pretty Peonies stamp set and a few other Sugar Pea Designs products. I wanted to color this beautiful peony with Copic markers. I love the detail that's in this beautiful floral, and I wanted to be able to do some really detailed coloring. I started off by coloring a base of color, leaving the tips of the petals white. I didn't want the color to go all the way to the edge because I knew I was going to be doing some blending, and as I'm blending things out, I knew I would get further down into the petals. So I started off by leaving a highlight. And then I started bringing in some darker colors. This one here is RV34. It's a really beautiful warm pink. And then I'm gonna also bring in some more pink colors. Another pink I used was RV17, and I was using that for the darkest areas. RV34 is the mid-tone, so I used that to blend out RV17. And then RV52, which was the color that I started off with for the base, that is blending out all of the colors into the tips of the petals. Now, I also colored the leaves. Those I used a couple of greens with. I really enjoy using G24, so I picked out G20 for the base color for that, and then I also used YG99 as the darkest color. It's a beautiful green that has some yellowish undertones. It's a really pretty color, and I used that for the darkest areas, like I said, and of course I blended those out to get a beautiful dimensional leaf. To create some additional dimension on this flower, I brought in some colored pencils. Colored pencils are so much fun to work with your Copic markers with because it allows you to get into those really teeny tiny details so much easier than if you were using a Copic marker. This is something that Kathy Rakusin does all the time, and I really enjoyed working with her at a coloring retreat a couple months ago, and she was showing me a few extra tips and tricks that really work well in getting some beautiful details. If you haven't checked out Kathy's YouTube channel and blog, I would encourage you to check her out. So after coloring this beautiful floral, I cut it out with my fine detail scissors, and now I'm going to start stamping the background that this flower will be sitting on. There's some beautiful smaller florals that are inside of this stamp set, so I'm going to use these to create a textured background so that way it has a little bit of interest behind my floral. I'm using a really light shade of ink. This is Morning Frost from Altenew. I really love the light tone of it, and it will get a little bit lighter as it dries back. Right now it's a little bit darker than what it will look like eventually. But I'm starting off by stamping the biggest images that I used, and then I'm going to work towards filling in with the smallest. I also cut that panel down with a memory box double stitched rectangle frame. I'm going to continue using all the pieces. I just wanted to have that beautiful textured frame popped up off of my card base, and then I'll nest the rest of it back into place with just some regular tape. So the frame will have dimension, and then the rest of the panel will be flat down on the card. Just adds a little bit of interest. I also decided I wanted to put a ribbon around my flower. So I'm taking a bit of hemp and I'm going to wrap this around my flower a couple times so that way I have a nice little bunch of ribbon, and then I'll tie this into a cute little bow. You don't have to do this, but I wanted to add a little bit of extra embellishing to this flower, and I thought that the twine would look really, really nice and add a little bit of a natural feel to this card. Adds to the elegance too, I think. Speaking of elegance, I'm going to use some beautiful fine tech gold watercolors and sprinkle some flecks of that rosy gold tone onto my card base, and that's going to give this card base some metallic splattering effects. It really looks beautiful. It's not super in your face once these dry back. Right now they look a little bit more warmer than what they'll look like once they dry into the paper. But it's a really beautiful way to add some nice texture and detail to your card base without having to be too distracting. I also wanted to tie in some more of that rose gold color, so I'm using some Burnished Rose Mirror Cardstock from Tonic Studios to cut this beautiful Mom Word die, which is part of the Mom Words die set from Sugar Pea Designs. I layered a few pieces of white cardstock behind the rose gold piece, and then I'm going to pop the entire sentiment up with some very small, tiny pieces of foam tape. And that's just going to give the sentiment a little bit more extra dimension. And by having those extra layers of cardstock layered behind the top layer, that gives it a little bit more of a sturdier feel to it, and that also helps it stand up better with the foam tape. I added a few Pretty Pink Posh rose gold sequins and some Morning Dew Nouveau drops into the centers of each of the sequins. It's one of my favorite techniques of adding these Nouveau drops into the sequins. For some reason, I really, really love the look of that domed effect, and it gives a beautiful tone to the sequins. It makes them really shiny and beautiful. If you enjoyed this video, I hope you will check it out over at my blog. You can click on the link here next to visit me. You can also subscribe to my channel, and I have two other videos here for you that you might find interesting. Thanks so much for joining me. I will be back again soon with more inspiration for you. And until then, thanks for watching.